welcome you to our national conclave, India Incorporation Moves Towards Flexi Staffing. To begin with the proceedings, may I request our chief guest, Director General of Employment and Training, Mr. Alok Kumar, to please come up on the stage and light the lamp. Thank you, sir. So, without further ado, may I request Rituparna Chakraborty to present the bouquet to our chief guest and Mr. Reddy to present him with a token. May I now request President ISF Rituparna Chakraborty to address the audience with about Indian Staffing Federation and the way forward. Thank you.
Good morning. India's painful reality is that we have 300 million kids who will never sit in the car that they clean, live in the house they build, or read the newspaper they deliver. The challenge that lies ahead of us is not just about employment opportunities for the youth, the million who are joining the workforce every month for the next 20 years, but it's also around innovations, around moving the 300 million adult workers into higher productivity. And such innovations need to address the five geographies of work. Enterprise geography of work. Out of the 63 million enterprises in India, only 9 lakh are registered. 45,000 of them are posting a job on one of the job sites any given day. And only 15,000 of them are doing so on a recurring basis. There are only 7,500 companies with a paid up capital of more than 10 crores. 84% of manufacturing happens in companies which has employees less than 50. Not for a minute I'm suggesting that small is bad, but not having the incentive to grow either by choice or compulsion on account of the regulatory cholesterol is bad. We need to make it easy to do business in India. We need to build access to non-collateral capital and, of course, build a healthy financial and regulatory regime. Physical geography of work. Do we take people to jobs or jobs to people? It has become practically impossible to fit in any more people across Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore without creating broader disparities. And even if we could, by building satellites like Gurgaon, Gachibowli, Whitefield, is it possible for each of those 300 million people to be able to make that shift? What happens to those who cannot make that shift? India has 43 cities as against China's 350. And hence, it's not much of a surprise that recently, during the Chinese New Year, 350 million Chinese workers went home. 25 million didn't return. What we need are real smart cities. Smart cities with 24/7 access to power, efficient infrastructure, highways, railways, airports, ports. The sectoral geography of work. 12% manufacturing employment is our nemesis. And agriculture is not a solution because of low productivity. 240 million Indians produce less milk, produce less food grains than 4 million Americans. You know, what started as China's promise of great infrastructure with low wages actually has gone on to raising their wage levels. 10 years back, it used to be 5% of the US wages. Today, it's 20%. And then our education geography of work. Around that, we need to acknowledge three realities. Number one, 265 lakh kids took the class 10th exam, 160 lakh passed. Out of the 160 lakh who took the class 12th exam, 80 lakh passed. And out of those 80 lakhs, only 50 lakhs went to college. There's barely any skilling framework available for those who fail at each level. College. It is not what it used to be, or so it seems like, given that soon 100% marks cutoff could be your chance to getting college admission. In Korea, 60% of the cab drivers today have a college degree. It used to be 5% in 1970. In US, 32% of the retail attendants today have a college degree. It used to be 1% in 1970. Closer home, in India, 15% of the security guards have a college degree. And yes, third, India just has 2.5 lakh apprentices, as against Germany's 3 million, Japan's 10 million, China's 20 million. And that too out of an overall meager capacity of 4 lakhs. And lastly, the regulatory geography of work. The debate isn't and shouldn't be between permanent versus contractual job. The actual debate has to be and needs to be between formal versus informal jobs. The labor regime has ensured that 94% of our workforce has been exiled to informality by design. You know, the challenge that lies ahead of us right now are 49% of wage confiscation as a patronizing form of social reform. Our trade unions, confused trade unions who probably do not know exactly whom they need to protect. And the regulatory flab, which is contradictory and shivers in the name of change. And lastly, an employment contract which is effectively marriage without divorce. Time has come for us to fix the benefits regime by actually giving employees three options. First, why not give them the choice of deciding whether they want to contribute their 12%, which is currently deducted from their PF, to the EPFO? Number two, why not give them the choice to decide whether the 12% of the employer contribution should go to EPFO or to NPS? And lastly, why not they have an option of deciding that their contribution to ESIC should go to ESIC or to any other IRDA-regulated health insurance? I believe flexi staffing is an important innovation. Each and every member of the Indian Staffing Federation are steadily contributing towards dealing with these five geographies of work. You may ask how. We are engaging with over 7,500 corporate organizations, employing 5 million youth over the last 10 years. We did that across 5,000 locations in 29 states. Our youth are currently engaged across 67 industries. More than 50% of our flexi workers are undergraduates. And over 70% of them actually leave us for a better career because they become more employable within 12 months of joining us. And yes, industries related to agriculture, construction, they're witnessing a steady shift into formal employment through flexi staffing. Can we fix the five dysfunctional geographies of work alone? Maybe not. But we can do what we do best, create jobs, create real quality jobs. And I must congratulate our new government for showing the kind of inertia which we've seen for the first time in the last 44 years around labor and skill. While it may not yet be comprehensive, it shows positive intent and an urgency to bring about change. The labor reform agenda, I believe, needs to essentially focus around the basics of fixing the minimum wages, Factories Act, Apprenticeship Act, all the social securities, and execute them. We also need to focus around streamlining and bringing about consistency in definitions. Time may not be right now to actually jump to the mother of all acts and try and fix the Section 5B of the Industrial Dispute Act. And of course, give greater autonomy to states. It is my privilege to have all of you here amidst us in the third edition of the National Conclave of Indian Staffing Federation. Your very presence in itself shows that we are on the right track. And it also motivates us to continue to carry on doing, performing our objective of creating more employment in this country. It is also our commitment, and it has been our commitment, and quite true to it, in terms of carrying out intuitive, in-depth studies around areas which have been previously untouched upon. We have, we are going to launch today shortly a report which captures the staffing landscape in the government and public sector. Before I proceed, thank you so much for being here today. I do hope that today's sessions, you have your distinct takeaways, that we mutually learn something to pave our path to creating more jobs in the country. I'd like to now call upon our honorable chief guest, the Director General of Employment and Training, Mr. Alok Kumar, to actually come and launch the report. Anmeri, could I request to also join us on stage for that? Coming.
Thank you, everyone. May I now request our chief guest, Director General of Employment and Training, Mr. Alok Kumar, to come up on the stage and share his views with us.
Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The President, Vice President of Indian Staffing Federation, President of CF. I'm very happy to be here this morning because I take this a good opportunity to get to know what this staffing